Hello there, and welcome to this video. Let's see quickly and easily all you need to know to start using Autodesk Revit 2018 for the first time. Please leave us suggestions and feedback in the video description to improve our next video guides for Autodesk Revit. Revit is a professional software used in a business environment in order to design and represent 3D buildings, architectural projects, and also 2D plans and maps. Here we will see the very basic features to start as a beginner, but you may need practice and experience to start designing professional projects. When opening Revit, a startup interface opens. On the left, you can manage Revit projects and families. The first ones are general projects containing several objects and templates, such as a whole house. Families are single objects that can be used as templates, such as single doors or windows. On the right, under Resources, you can check the latest information and updates from Autodesk and its community. In order to understand how to use Revit, let's design a very simple house. To start with a Revit project, go to New, and let's choose a default construction template and a general Revit project by choosing Project under Create New. When you go to OK below, the whole Revit workspace opens. On top, you have the menu bar with all the main drawing and editing tools inside Revit. On the left, we will see some important panels, and on the right, the main visualization tools to check and preview your project. To start drawing, you have to use the several tabs under the menu bar. Architecture is used to drop fundamental objects, structure to draw load-bearing objects, and systems to drop conductors and tubes. In this video, we will just see the architecture section. Inside the build section, you have several tools to draw specific objects, such as walls, doors, or windows. These may also show a black arrow, which is used to show all the tools correlated to the main one. Hover over one tool to get additional information and help on it. To design a simple house, it is better to draw from bottom to top, from the floor to the roof. To draw floors, you can use the floor tool, for example, the architectural one. When the tool is enabled, the Modify section appears, used to change the way to draw the floor. For example, choose Line to drop straight floor sides by clicking on your workspace. Choose Arc or Spline to drop curved sides instead. If you choose these tools, make sure to create closed paths to realize the floor successfully. Choose Rectangle, Polygon, Circle, or Ellipse to draw a closed shape that will be directly used to realize the floor by fixing two or more points on your workspace. While drawing, Revit helps you by showing side length and angle measurements with respect to the horizontal direction, and by also allowing snappings to object endpoints, midpoints, and guidelines parallel to points and directions. You can also fix your pointer for some time to get help. If you make a mistake, you can undo your current drawing by using the Escape key. The current pink drawings or sketches made represent the current floor being in progress. In this case, Revit is in the edit mode. When you finish drawing, you can decide whether to apply the creation of the floor with the current sketch by using Finish Edit Mode, or remove any sketch by using Cancel Edit Mode. Once the sketches are applied, these will be dropped as a floor with filling and volume, according to the tool used. You can see it from a top view and check it by zooming in and out with your mouse wheel. In case you do not see your floors, go to the View tab and then to Visibility Graphics, and make sure to enable floors in the list. Remember to save your project often. Go to File, Save As, and then choose Project. Revit projects are saved with a RVT format file, saving the complete status of your project. Now let's see how to edit your objects. First of all, enable the Modify tool in the top left corner and select the object to edit by clicking on it. This will be highlighted in blue. Use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V to cut, copy, and paste the selected object. Use the Delete key to remove the object from your project. In case you make a mistake, remember to use Ctrl and Z to undo. Furthermore, you can use the editing tools under the Modify tab. Use the Move tool to move a selected object by fixing two points on your workspace. The Copy tool works in the same way, with the difference that you create a new copy of the selected object. Use the Rotate tool to rotate an object by fixing the rotation angle. You can also choose a different rotation point by clicking and dragging it. The Mirror tool is used to flip the object according to an axis that you can pick or draw. If you choose Mirror, Draw Axis, fix two points to draw the axis and mirror the object according to it. All the tools applied on objects do not change their original shape. To edit it, you must come back to the object sketch by enabling the Edit mode with the Edit Boundary button. On the object sketches, you can apply the editing tools on the single sides of the floor and not on the whole object only. So, by moving and rotating its sides, you will also edit the overall shape of the object. Furthermore, you can also edit the shape by clicking and dragging each of its sides and vertices, indicated by blue nodes, and moving them, or by using the drawing tools again. Just remember to realize closed paths before exiting from the edit mode. Editing tools can be applied on multiple selected objects or sketches as well in order to edit all of them in the same way. To make multiple selections, just click on each object or sketch while holding Ctrl down, or click and hold on and include everything that has to be selected within the rectangle. Then, apply the editing tools. To undo all selections, just click on your workspace. You can quickly enable the latest tool by using the Enter key. If you make any mistake, use Ctrl and Z to undo your latest actions. After defining a floor, you can go on with the house walls. Differently from the floors that lay on the ground plane or any plane parallel to it, the walls lay on the ground plane only with their base and spread through the third dimension with their defined height. Enable the Wall tool to start drawing walls. You should choose Wall Architectural to make general walls and Wall Structural for load-bearing walls. Let's just see the first ones in this video. Fix points on your workspace to draw the wall. The drawing tools on top and the way to manage the sketch are identical to the floors. Just remember that are not obliged to make closed paths, and also walls merge if they intersect. The top default view is good to fix the wall perimeter, but not to define its height. You can switch to a direct 3D preview by going to the View tab and then to 3D View. In this way, you will get a complete preview through all the three directions, length, width, and height. You can also change the point of view by using the 3D viewcube in the top right corner, or by using the pan or the orbit command inside the full navigation wheel. You can also use Project Browser Panel on the far left. This lists all the project content from objects to view used. you can open any view by double-clicking on it. The default top view is called Level 1 under Floor Plans, whereas the latest 3D view is under 3D. You also have the elevation views. By default, these preview your project from east, north, south, and west. One elevation view per each marker you see from the default Level 1 view. You can also create your custom elevation by going to View, Elevation, and then clicking on your workspace. Use the Escape key to finish. Each marker is composed by a square that you can click and drag to move or rotate by using the Rotate button, and by an arrow that represents the direction of the elevation. If you click on it, you can manage its depth and side view range. To apply, click Outside. Through an elevation view, you can check and edit the object's height, such as walls. By default, these go from the ground plane, or Level 1, to the next floor plan, Level 2, but you can personalize it as you like. You have multiple floor plan levels on your project, each representing a preview from top to bottom at a different height from the ground or zero level. On elevation views, these are represented as dashed lines with their name and height level from the ground. You can add custom levels by going to Level under the Architecture tab and then fixing two points to fix height and length. Use the Escape key to apply. Custom levels and elevations are all listed in the project browser. Right-click and go to Rename to rename these. Also, level and elevation markers can be moved and edited as seen for drawings. After floors and walls, you have to add doors and windows. Since these lay on walls, you should choose either an elevation or a 3D full view. To place doors, enable the Door tool and place it on a wall. Their base will automatically lay on a floor plan level. To place windows, enable the Window tool and place them on a wall freely. To change and personalize the object appearance and size, select it and check the Properties panel on the left. In the case of Revit families, such as doors or windows, you can also select the right template to use by going to Edit Family on top. Check out the video description for more Revit templates. To finish with the basic house, you have to drop its roof. This object is very similar to the floors, with the difference that the roof should be placed on top of the walls, so on a different height, respect to the ground plane. To do so, you have to change the work plane reference. The work plane is the floor plan level taken as a reference to drop objects that do not spread in height, such as floors and roofs. By default, the Level 1 ground is taken as a reference, so the next roofs are all dropped on the ground plane. To change the reference, click on Set under the Architecture tab and change the level from Level 1 to Roof. If you enable the Show button, you can see that the work plane moves from the ground plane to the roof level. At this point, use the roof level or the 3D view to draw the roof in the same way as seen for the floors. When applied, the roof looks like a simple flat block. You can customize its basic shape by going to Edit Footprint and add slope and depth by using the tools inside the Shape Editing section. For example, use Add Point to add points and Add Split Line to add lines on the roof. When points and lines are placed, click on Modify Sub Elements to click and drag these in order to shape the overall roof appearance. Use the Escape key to finish with the tool. To reset the roof shape instead, use Reset Shape on top. You can also change the way to see your objects by changing the visual style at the very bottom. To check a more realistic preview on your project, try the Render button under the View tab. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides for Autodesk software and more.